At this point in his development, Bo was actually in advance of many human children of the same age. He was aware of his surroundings and he was interacting well with others. Like human children, Bo was being exposed to language in its natural environment. He was being socialized by participating in family events and everyday life. And it was clear that he understood much of the language to which he was exposed. The original research plan called for the use of the Easytalk digital playback device manufactured by Sim Systems Corporation of San Jose, California. One unit was made available to the project through the generous contributions of Dr. Nets Hawk Cutts. The Easytalk device allows for 8 templates to coexist simultaneously in memory to be flipped through by pressing a switch. Chimpanzees are articulatorily impaired by reason of biological makeup. They cannot form consonants and have difficulty with many vowels. Using this system, where each key stood for a particular lexigram and each lexigram was represented in its conventional orthography, such a system is of help because it does not require articulation. Bo was not expected to read the English words phonetically. As with the Chinese characters, he was to form a holistic gestalt of the lexigram in whatever language he was exposed to. When Bo was only a year old, he was not able to press a particular key at will in order to hear the words. The problem was not one of strength or pressure. Instead, the user is required to keep the key pressed for several seconds, and this seems counterintuitive even to humans who expect an immediate response.
When Bo was about 18 months old, a favorite thing that he liked to do using the Easytalk device was to run through the levels.
Level 3, level 4, level 5,
kept doing that over and over again. That and chewing on the cover and the templates that were placed inside. Eventually, we had to take out the templates from inside the Easytalk, and we found that it was just as easy to use them to communicate without the device.
Bo first began training in English with Deborah Driesel in June of 2003. Ms. Driesel is a professional educator who specializes in teaching children with learning disabilities. The English training sessions consisted of 1 hour long concentrated periods of intense interaction twice a week from June of 2003 to June of 2004. June Sun and Delight Wang returned to Missouri in July of 2003, and they stayed in the household for 6 months until the end of December 2003. During that time, Bo received intensive training from June Sun in Chinese twice a week, as well as a great deal of casual interaction in Chinese with both Ms. Sun and her daughter Delight.
In February of 2004, Bo turned 2, and Deborah Driesel was still working with him. Occasionally, they used a template such as this, and Bo would say things like, "I want to eat," and then, when he said it, he would get something to eat. Incidentally, Bo recognized the word eat, even when he had never seen this template before. He was so familiar with eat. But something was missing. And by the time that Bo turned 3, it was obvious that at least from a human standpoint, he had missed a few developmental steps. And it had nothing to do with pronunciation of words, which obviously he can't do for physical reasons. And it had nothing to do with failing to recognize or understand words, because he demonstrated great ability in those areas. But there was still a problem. Small children, are you trying to say something? Sleep. You want to go sleep? Okay, a little bit later. Later. Later, but we'll sleep. We'll take a nap. Other children, even before they're speaking, can be asked questions such as, "Where is your nose? Where's your nose, Bo?" Ifa af shilcha. Ifa af. Ifa af. Ifa af. Ifa af. Ifa af. They can be asked, "Where are your ears? Where are your ears?" And they'll point at their noses and their ears and their mouths and their eyes. And this is an important pre-linguistic step. While Bo clearly understood what the parts of his body were, he would never play that game.
Ironically, just as I said that he wouldn't play that game, Bo pointed at his nose. It's often the case nowadays, when Bo is much more aware, that he seems to express his understanding of conversations he overhears by his gestures.
Wouldn't show me his finger. "Is that your nose? If that af shilcha, what does it? If a af, if a af." It is said that chimpanzees are lacking in a theory of mind. That's the big difference, and that's why they don't use language the way we do. Tickle? Tickle? Tick-tock? Don't say tick-tick? Well, when Bo turned 3, we adopted a new strategy for the project. And that strategy involved play therapy.